We've actually already had a very busy semester with the Purdue Jazz Band, a number of performances already, but this is our first really formal performance of this version of the Purdue Jazz Band, and we're really excited to get a chance to play for you. To open up the program today, we're going to start with one of our combos. This is one of our talented guitarists, Justin Offit, is kind of leading up this effort, and they're going to play this selection called Kyoto by Tomo Fujita. It's going to feature Alan Mobley-Burgess on piano, Lucas Lewitt on bass, and Jackson Ferry Zamora on drums, and of course, Justin Offit on guitar.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. All right. There's a lot of talent up here on this stage. Some really exceptional players. And you're going to get a chance to hear a lot of great music from them. Tonight, we're going to be featuring the music of one of the great artists of the last half of the 20th century into the 21st century, a saxophonist who really was, most people see as the successor to John Coltrane as far as a great tenor saxophonist. He was I'll call him a young man because he was only 6 years older than I am. And he was, unfortunately his life was cut short due to a blood disorder a form of leukemia that they couldn't find a proper match for a bone marrow transplant. So it was very tragic that we lost him so early. But he went on, I mean, he was one of the most magnetic players and certainly one of the most incredible technicians on the saxophone that there ever was. But he was also one of these guys from a period of music where jazz musician who didn't see rock as an enemy. You know, he embraced rock and all that rock could be and kind of carried on the mantle of people like Miles Davis and John McLaughlin and some of the other great players of the 1960s, but then took it to new places and made it something that everyone could relate to. It was not elitist music at all. Incredible saxophonist Michael Brecker is who we're talking about. And in the 1970s, he got together with his brother, who was a phenomenal trumpet player as well. And they formed a group that was called the Brecker Brothers. And this was a group that was really very, very popular, lots of critical acclaim and mass appeal when they were recording their great recordings of the early 70s. In fact, that was during a time when I was in college and I was learning about jazz. And of course, all of us were listening to the Brecker Brothers because, wow, what an incredible band that was. We're gonna take one of those pieces. This is a piece that Randy Brecker wrote, but he and Michael Brecker played it together. This is called Some Skunk Funk. And we're gonna feature Evan Abrams on tenor saxophone and Dan Gui on trumpet. They're gonna be the Brecker Brothers today. Here is Some Skunk Funk. By the way, you may have noticed we have somebody you've seen before sitting on the end of the saxophone section. He's filling in for us tonight on Barry Sax. Gerard is playing because our Barry Sax, regular Barry Sax player, had a school function that was tonight where he had to be out of town and there was absolutely nothing that he could do about it. So, luckily, we have a wonderful saxophone player on staff and he was able to fill in tonight. So, thank you, Gerard. Here is Some Skunk Fun. Thank you. Williams on tenor sax. Dan Green on the trumpet. Some stuff. The thing about Michael Brecker, he was an incredible technician. They say at the height of his powers, he could play a whole concert by himself and hold everybody spellbound. He just had such command of his instrument. We're going to play a piece that kind of represents a little bit of that. And we've got another wonderful tenor saxophonist. This is Kevin Brainer, who's going to serenade us to Delta City Blues.
Thank you.
Burgos on the piano. And now for something completely different, we're going to bring out Julia Maleta to sing a beautiful tune that you probably haven't heard before, but I think you're going to love it. This is going to feature Julia. As we say, it's also going to feature Sean Hun on the alto saxophone. Here is The Invisible Girl. Jazz. Now, Michael Brecker wasn't just a jazz aficionado. I mean, he was a great jazz aficionado, but he didn't just play pop songs and straight-ahead jazz things. He played with Joni Mitchell. He played with Bruce Springsteen. He was on the Saturday Night Live band. I mean, he did all of these great things, but he kept making really fine jazz records. And one of the groups that he led was a group called Steps Ahead, and this is a piece that kind of came from that era. You think of it as a little bit more straight ahead. This is called Midnight Voyage, and we're going to feature both of our tenor saxophonists on this, Evan and Kevin. Thank you. Kevin Abrams. Kevin Brandon. We're going to bring up our other brother and sister, Sarah Nalinton. And Sarah's going to sing an unusual song for us, one that we don't really delve into this kind of music that often. But this is called The Grass Is Greener.
Thank you.
Serena Lindgren, Joe Lewis. Serena, give us a nice round. Wonderful. We have one more selection we'd like to play. This is another one that that Michael Brecker did with his brother Randy Brecker. And this one is called Strap Hangin'. I'm not exactly sure what that means, but I know if you're hanging by a strap, you know, you hope that strap is strong, right? Because anything could happen, and that's what we want on this. We don't want that strap to break. So we're gonna feature our Brecker brothers here and the band on a very difficult arrangement. Here is Strap Hangin'.
Thank you.
so much. This is the Purdue Jazz Band. Thank you so much. What a pleasure to be back in Globe playing jazz for you wonderful people. Thank you. Hey, we have another concert next Friday night. American Music Repertory Ensemble and our two lab bands will be here performing right here on this very stage at 8 o'clock. Hope to see you then. Bring more friends. Thank you.